Hello everyone, welcome to my presentation of Castle Danger Brewery Strategic Planning Presentation. Castle Danger Brewery is a small business and manufacturer that creates their own alcoholic beverages and distributes them to the surrounding community storefronts. The business is also from a small town called Two Harbors, Minnesota, and they also partner up with the local Chamber of Commerce when events are scheduled. The COVID-19 pandemic has impacted many small businesses financially for the worse. Many businesses didn't really have a risk management plan in place to minimize their risk. These outcomes gives a greater realization to how important a risk management strategy is. Everything can be improved from the original plan. Castle Danger Brewery has already had in place a great foundation for operations. In the business of selling adult beverages comes with the problems of extra factors placed on laws and regulations of the distribution of alcohol. Since Castle Danger Brewery is a small business, they will have limited risk management plan and resources from the business owners rather than a corporate government's guidance. Corporate government is usually comprised of a board of directors. During times of economic crisis, a plan to stabilize a business is important for restructuring and reorganizing. The reorganizing and restructuring of the business is not only for strategic risk management, but is also for all business operations and infrastructure. The importance of strategic planning allows the business's executives to keep tabs on the progression of goals. Organizational goals are the goals that the strategic plan strives for. These goals pushes the boundaries and explore new opportunities. The impact of strategic planning on the organizational goals can create and improve new products and increase productivity throughout the business. Castle Danger can benefit from strategic planning by opening another brewery and can distribute their product throughout the Midwest rather than the whole state of Minnesota. The plan for expansion will have new opportunities for improving and innovating new drinks to the menu. Castle Danger will also have a place in the strategic plan that would oversee their objectives that have been progressing on the right track. New products could be made into flavors associated with the seasons or food trends. The business could also expand in another area that would be in the south of Minnesota to cover more ground of the state. The first step in the strategic plan process would be to identify the underlying issues within the business and to determine their strategic position within the marketplace. Castle Danger will need to analyze their current business operations, tactics, and distribution of products to see if any of their underlying weaknesses can be improved upon. The second step would be to create the objectives that the business will need to complete. This would be their operational goals for Castle Danger to expand their business operations and would be the time to prioritize which objectives would need to be complete first to benefit the business, whether it would be long-term or short-term goals. The development of the strategic plan would implement the strategies to be put in place to achieve organizational goals. The strategic plan is set up for Castle Danger to expand across the states in the Midwest and even distribute the border spectrum in the Midwest. without a plan of action to complete goals will be a failure. This is the reason that the fourth step would be to execute and manage the strategic plan. This role would be tasked to management and supervisors, along with the business owners. They're already in charge of overseeing the employees with daily operational tasks. You can continuously execute, manage operations, but there will need to be a checkpoint when the objectives becomes complete. This is the fifth step, which is a review and revise the plan. This will be the checkpoint to see if the strategic plan is going according to plan. This would also give an opportunity to give the business owners a chance to revise the plan. An example of capital danger would be to change the location of their new brewery that would fit the strategic plan better than before. The COVID-19 pandemic is one of the biggest pandemics in history. During the events of the past years, we saw government lock down civilians to protect each other from getting sick. The virus is easily contagious. During the lockdowns, businesses were not able to operate besides the necessary businesses that provide human necessities. With most businesses shut down meant that there was little to no in-person transactions being completed. Most transactions were being completed online. The government shut down the manufacturers often led to a shortage of supplies of raw materials to make a finished product. The government was trying to protect people to prevent the virus from getting even more out of hand that would affect more people than just pockets, but their health and safety. The pandemic was a domino effect and left the global economy to decline drastically and inflation increased. This overview provides a necessary strategic plan to avoid any business from getting negatively impacted. Altering the business operations is one of the best ways to mitigate losses from external factors. Analyzing capital danger's current business strategy is the first step to take for a quick adaptability. Gathering enough surplus of raw materials to package and create the finished product in the brewery that would otherwise prevent from having an incomplete finished product. When the CDC guidelines has loosened up as time went by, then change the daily business operations that would follow the guidelines. This is important when the customers are starting to come into the business and purchase the product and to socialize to make sure the business is clean and has the right rules in place. Having a quick adaptation plan for any scenario is a good way to restructure the plan that would benefit the business the most. The change in business operations would have employees working with masks on and cleaning tables constantly and sanitizing everything that is being used to reduce the spread of the virus. Organizational infrastructure consists of systems and protocols that support the business's key function and are also the elements of organizational infrastructure. These elements consist of technology, production process, reporting dashboards, customer service process, change management, and human capital. Technology is the foundation of the business because it depends on real-time data and results. The production process is a production line to create the finished goods. Reporting dashboards tracks the strategic plans to see if they're succeeding or failing. Customer service process are the first line of communication with the business's customers to make sure they're satisfied. Change management shifts cultures and strategic thinking within the business. Human capital are the backbone of the business, and without them, the business cannot exist. This connects to Castle Danger by the technology being the data inventory. Production process is the manufacturing of the craft beer. Reporting dashboard would be the data tracking business operations to see if they're running smoothly. The customer service are the employees serving the customer's drinks. Change management would be the change from management to enforce the new strategic plan. And the human capital runs and operate daily business activities. Organizational infrastructure relates to strategic planning through organizational capabilities. Organizational capabilities are intangible strategic assets that act as a blueprint business planning operations, work completion, and satisfy their customers. Organizational capabilities of a business are important to maintain the structured guidance of the business success. Another way that it helps out is that organizational capabilities aid to achieve strategic competitive advantage. The reason that organizational capabilities relate to strategic planning is the utilization of the assets. Organizational infrastructure affects the strategic plan by supporting the plans. This relates to Castle Danger by utilizing their organizational capabilities and infrastructure to support their strategic plan with the aid of intangible resources from the business records. Strategies are described as analyzing multiple plans to execute a plan of action to strive towards the organizational goal. Every plan is also a tactic to which leads the analyzation of future moves. Policies are usually associated with ethics and principles that would be used in making rules and regulations for an organization. The main differences between them are that strategy is a comprehensive plan to execute goals, and policies is the guiding principles for making logical decisions. This relates to Castle Danger by the strategies being executed and managed while the policies are in place to make the right decisions, making by everyone within the business. Gap analysis are different methods of assessing business performance to determine if the business objectives are being met. The risk management is not also just external, but also internal. These are organizational deficiencies and happens when there's a lack of direction, goals and objectives, misuse of allocating resources, and issues with organizational structure along with communication would also be organizational deficiencies. This relates to Castle Danger By using different methods to analyze business performance and to also identify the organizational deficiencies. The SWOT analysis for strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. The strengths for castle dangers are an established brand, distribution of products, and their interior layout. The weaknesses are the brewery is in one location, no food served within the business, and no sale of growlers. The opportunities are expanding across the state, distributing across the Midwest, and have community events planned inside the business. The threats are the laws and regulations, potential raw material shortage, and competitors on store shelves. The rules and regulation hinders opportunities for breweries to grow beyond their individual status. Risk management is the process of identifying and assessing external threats and prioritize which threats would be minimized the most. One of the main important reasons to have a strategic risk management plan would be to minimize losses in an unfortunate event that impacts a business. One way to assess a risk management would be to create a contingency plan for the business. The role of corporate governance is a risk management system that directs and controls daily operations within the organization. Risk management system could be an individual, committee, or board of directors within the organization. The corporate governance is also in control of private information, and when leaked out, would take legal action against them. This relates to castle danger by having a safety net that will minimize risk and losses from external threats and will oversee private business information. Thank you, everyone, for giving me your attention on my castle danger strategic planning presentation. If you have any questions, just ask or contact me through different communication channels. Have a great day, everyone.